Some sealer manufacturers say their products are bulletproof. That must mean Granite Shield is missile-proof. All right, we're about to seal light granite, so this is the first step in sealing light granite. I'll show you how it's done. Spray it into your hand so you don't overspray anything. Rub it into the edges, and then coat the surface. Apply a line. Continue. So that you get plenty of penetration, and by rubbing it with your hand, you're pushing it down into the pores, making sure you get the whole thing. Around the sink, you want to cup it down in and get along the edge. Make sure you coat that very well so you don't get any penetration. Always do the edge of your granite. Where it's hardest to seal the water out, so you want to make sure you coat that very well. Since this gets the most use in the kitchen right here. I'm going to continue. Two different directions, you'll ensure that you don't miss any spots. The sealer, you might find some spots where it's rough. That's where you're going to get a razor blade and clean it off. Here we've got a rough spot, so all you do is put your razor blade at an almost 45 degree angle, go back and forth, don't go sideways, and you'll be able to remove any residue. Usually there's silicone or epoxy left on the counter after installation, or if you're doing your own, there might be some sugar water or syrup or something sticking to it. Don't get any chemical on the cabinet, just squirt into your hand and then rub it along the edge. Make sure you get it right up to the edge of the cabinet. And then continue applying as you go. Again, finding residue on the counter, just scrape it off with a razor blade. As as you can see, there's variations in the granite that are different minerals, which are different hardnesses, and therefore take a different polish. So all your granite will not be the same amount of shine because of hardness and softness in the material. And as you can see, you've got hard and soft in here. You've got shiny and dull, and that's the variations you'll find in the minerals in granite. Now we're about to do next the stove, and because it's real tight and the stove can't be moved, we're going to flood this area, and we're going to get it right down inside. Don't worry about getting it on the metal. We're going to wipe that off afterwards, and it won't leave any residue, and it doesn't hurt the metal. But we're just saturating it so that it goes down and fills that whole side of it to keep it from staining from the inside underneath the sealer. Then we'll just wipe it off the stove like that. Check where we first started at and see if we're starting to be half dry. It's still saturated, so it's not ready to buff yet. So we will continue finishing the application. About to start buffing at the beginning, and as you can see, the stone has absorbed the sealer and it's very dark now. So what we're going to do is buff the residue off the surface, and then it'll start evaporating and get ready for the second step. You just want to put the towel on, hold the buffer on lightly so it spins. That removes the residue and dries the granite at the same time. When it's this porous, the sealer penetrates very deep, and it's probably going to take at least an hour before this evaporates out. You can already see an improvement in the shine just after the first application. Thank you. clean the granite first, you can see that the sealer actually penetrates and pulls dirt up out of the stone itself, making it cleaner as you seal. After you buff with the white terry cloth towel, then you switch to a microfiber towel to remove the rest of the residue. Completed the first step of light granite application, and now we're going to go to lunch and let it cure for an hour before we come back and do another step on it, and then we'll continue with the process. Okay, we've let the countertop cure about 1 hour. Now we're going to reapply step one again because this is a very porous stone, and we're going to do the same process all over again. Just spray on and rub it in. Applied the second coat of step one, and we're just going to buff it off. Got a little darker this time, but not very much because we already had a good penetrated seal of the first coating. I'm going to buff again with the microfiber towel to remove all the excess residue. You can do that at the last step, or you can do it in between steps to make sure that you have a smooth polish finish. And we're going to put the third process on for light granite, and because it's a tile and grout backsplash, this is the perfect time to do the backsplash before you do the counter. Because when you spray it up here, it'll fall down there and just seal. So we're going to start up here, but we're going to use a white rag, terry cloth towel, and we're just going to spray on.
Or some would refer to it as a cotton white towel.
A cotton terry cloth towel. Thank you. just want to make sure that all your grout is turning bark and that you're getting it applied evenly. Wipe off the excess and rub it into the stone. Applying the sealer to the tile, we're going to take a dry terry cloth and just buff the surface. Now we've sealed the backsplash, we're going to seal the countertop. Again, with the same process, spray, rub in, and just make sure you coat the whole countertop. Make sure you get along the grout line so you get this area that's susceptible to staining. Along the sink again, cup your hand and push the sealer down onto the edge so that it can't stain. Make sure when you're sealing that you have already got some good caulking in between the sink and the countertop, because if water goes under the counter, it can leach up through the bottom. So always caulk, make sure it's a tight seal all the way around, and then you can seal right over it. As you can see, the countertop is starting to dry, and that's the time to buff it. When it's half dry, then you put your towel down and start removing the sealer. Step of the sealer for light granite. So we're going to start on the tile again, go all the way around, buff it off, come back and do the countertop. So we're going to spray on and rub in. After I've sealed the backsplash, I use a microfiber towel just to remove any residue and leave a nice shine on the marble and tile. And this is all you have to do is just give it a wipe down.
Or you can use a white terry cloth towel.
Yes, you could use a white terry cloth towel. When we finish the backsplash, we're going to seal the countertop with number four. Our fourth application, and same process as before. Coat it, rub it in. Again, we're going to start buffing as soon as it's half dry, and if you can see this, you've got dry spots and wet spots, and that's exactly what you're looking for before you buff it off. We're going to use a white microfiber cotton towel on this application.
White cotton towel.
White cotton
terry cloth towel.
We are now on our fifth step of the granite shield process. This is our carbon crystal nanotechnology. This is a permanent bond with the stone, locking in the other sealers that we've already applied. Put it on the same way as before, spray on, rub in. You'll actually feel when you run out of chemical, your glove will start sticking. And you just apply more and continue the process.
It's also fast drying.
It's very fast drying, and you don't have to continually apply it. Once it hits the stone, it catalyzes instantly and you're done. You've applied the fifth step. Just use a white terry cloth towel to rub it in. You're not trying to buff it off. You're going to use a microfiber towel for that. All you're going to do is make sure it's evenly spread and just use a white terry cloth towel for that as the way to do it.
It's fast drying. You don't want to let it completely dry.
You should only do about 8 to 10 feet at a time of countertop. So I did approximately 10 feet. Now I'm just buffing it in, and then I'll buff it off. This way I have complete coverage all the way around the countertop. After we rubbed in the number 5 step, I'm just going to buff it off, and then you'll see beautiful shine left over, and your countertop is almost complete. On light granite, we're going to repeat the fourth step, and we're going to again spray it on. We'll just rub it in, and once you do that, you buff it off with a microfiber towel, and you're done. Step is to buff the microfiber towel, leaving it clean and shiny granite. Step on light granite. After 24 hours, a wipe down with the clean and shine. So make sure if you're an applicator, you leave it for the customer, and customers ask for it by name. The nanotechnology carbon crystal makes the granite smoother. The clean and shine makes it shinier.